mention the full lineup for this women's 1500 meters. Marianne Bugyar, the 21-year-old Hungarian, is really an 800-meter runner, and Marta Vishnye, I hope I've pronounced that correctly, though I very much doubt it, another 21-year-old. And along with Chris Boxer, Yvonne Murray, who really is in outstanding form and ran magnificently here against Zolabud in the 3A's Indoor Championships. There's Yvonne Murray, number four. Number three is Vishnye. That's Chris Boxer, number two. And number one, Bugyar. Yes, you must stay behind the line. Seven and a half laps of the track then in this women's 1500 meters. And I dare say on this occasion, the British duo will be running very much as a team. Chris Boxer and Yvonne Murray speaking at length before the race started and deciding on their tactics. Often a slow and tactical race indoors, this distance for women. And certainly both the British girls relatively inexperienced indoors.
Yes, well, I think, Alan, that our two here today are a class apart from the Hungarians. Not being unkind to Hungarians, but Christina's come through tremendously in the last two or three years. And I think, you know, she's obviously getting out front there to stretch her legs, to find out what the surface is like, to sort of experience running around the bends without having any problems of bumping or boring with the rest of the runners. And I think as the race goes on, really, we see these two pulling further and further away. It's just a matter of seeing whether they've actually developed a race plan of sharing laps or whatever, and seeing who, you know, what happens with about two or three laps to go, whether they're actually going to battle it out or run in together, really.
So Chris Boxer, number two, leads. Yvonne Murray wearing the blue vest beneath her new British strip, wearing number four also in second place. Number three is Vishnye, and number one, Bugyar.
At a fairly steady pace for the first 400 metres, just 68 seconds.
Chris Boxer, who will be defending her Commonwealth title over this distance in Edinburgh later this year. And Yvonne Murray, who will be running in her home city when she represents Scotland, which I'm sure she will do. Not selected yet, of course, but one of the outstanding young Scottish athletes. The 21-year-old from Edinburgh Athletics Club. Yvonne Murray really in the best form of her life, judging on that run behind Zolabud last month. She improved her best by no less than 5 seconds. And it was a very tenacious race, which certainly was appreciated by Zolabud, who might otherwise have found herself out up front with little pressure. Yvonne Murray developing as a very stylish, very able runner. And clearly, Boxer and Murray talked this race through beforehand and have decided to share the leadership. And Yvonne Murray, who now incidentally runs in contact lenses, should help her to see the lap marker this time round, which says three to go.
Yes, it's been worked out obviously beforehand. Yvonne's really pushing the pace on a bit here. I think she obviously fears that Christine's got a little bit of a kick, and she wants to try and get clear of her if she can with about a lap to go. But Christine is one of the strongest competitors I think I've seen. She's a very determined young lady, and if she wants to stick in there and use Yvonne as a pacemaker for the last two or three laps, I think she will do, and then use obviously her superior speed over the last lap, Alan.
And in fact, they've just passed 1,000 metres in a pretty good time of 2 minutes 49.
And with two laps to go, the lead is enormous now. Yvonne Murray and Chris Boxer are almost the length of a straight away from the Hungarian duo. So as far as points are concerned, Britain will be bringing maximum points home surely in this match, barring any mishaps.
Yes, I think what happens at this stage is that they've done the pacemaker together, and now it becomes a personal battle as to who actually wins first place. So I think in the last lap, obviously, Christine might try and muster a big sprint for the finish line.
Yes, it is going to be a fascinating battle indeed over the final 200 metres as Boxer moves through to take the lead with only a lap to go. Murray not beaten yet, she'll fight back at her. But Boxer, the experienced girl, the classy athlete, Yvonne Murray, proving that she has the potential, but Boxer has the skill and the finishing speed when it matters. And it's it's a runaway victory because the Hungarians are on the other side of the track. A massive lead then for Chris Boxer, and Yvonne Murray comes in second place. So 5 points for the winner, Chris Boxer, and three for Yvonne Murray. 4:10 the time. So a good time for Boxer, though, capable of much better, of course. And on her first appearance at Cosford, she has won maximum points and looked impressive indeed in this emphatic victory over the two Hungarians.
Yes, it's a good performance for Christine there for her first race. And she actually put in a 32 last lap, which is very, very fast pace for women at that particular distance. So it wasn't surprising that she actually pulled away from Yvonne, but that's a good performance there, Alan, and it's points that really matter in matches like this, and we've got one and two again. The women are doing exceptionally well today.
And now we can look back at a couple of earlier field events. First of all, it's the women's events, the women's long jump.
1,500 metres. On the left-hand side of the picture, running, in fact, as a guest, not as a scoring member of the British team, Yvonne Murray. The rest of the field in a moment. 7.5 laps of the track then, and Yvonne Murray getting right out in front. And what a contrast in fortunes she had at the weekend compared to the girl wearing number three here, Kirsty McDermott. So disappointed with her performance in the 800 metres. But the girl who's gone out in front and slowing it down, it seems, number two there, Svetlana Kitova, had the most successful weekend of all because she won the gold medal in Madrid in this event. So it's Kitova, number two, who leads. Number five is Yvonne Murray. Coming through there, number four, Romanova, who's already run tonight in the 3,000 metres, in which she finished third. So the Soviets, one and two. McDermott wearing number three, running alongside Yvonne Murray. And at the rear of the field at the moment is Kath Carter wearing number one. Six laps to go. Steve Ovett.
It's good to see the Russian out in front there because she's quite a fast finisher, actually, Alan, and Kirsty would like to see her up in front so that she's got something to gauge her performance by. Kirsty obviously had a disappointing run in Madrid, but I think she's got the capability of running really well here. And at the moment, Yvonne's actually come up on the shoulder of the Russian, and perhaps she thinks, well, with her strength that she'll push the pace on in the latter stages of the race.
Time in the first 400 metres, 1:10.51. So as Stephen's saying, fairly slow. And we've just had one good bit of news from Britain, that Helen Thorpe, second in the women's 800 metres, a personal best, 2:04.53.
You're watching the women's 1,500 metres. Kitova of the Soviet Union is the leader. Yvonne Murray wearing number five, running as a guest in the race in second place. Kirsty McDermott wearing three in third place. Kath Carter, a former United Kingdom champion, wearing number one. And not surprisingly, they're beginning to lose Romanova, who has already been in action tonight in the 3,000 metres and must be feeling very, very tired. This time round, four laps to go. Steve, Yvonne Murray running in second place there must have all the confidence in the world at the moment.
Yeah, she must do, but I think she's got to really get out there and push the pace a little bit, actually, Alan, because the other girls around her are quite fast at the finish, and Yvonne obviously relies on her strength to win races, not a fast finish. But it's interesting to see that Kirsty's tucking in behind there. She's obviously going to think, she's obviously thinking that she can outkick perhaps the Russian Kitova at the finish, but we saw Kitova actually put a very fast and aggressive finish in Madrid when she came down busting with her teammate. So perhaps in the last couple of laps here, it could be quite an interesting race.
Three to go. Kitova, Murray, McDermott and Carter. The other Russian is out of it. Kirsty McDermott running wide on the left-hand side of the picture. Better known, of course, as an 800-metre runner, but recently run 1,500 metres indoors in North America. And she comes aggressively to the shoulder of the leader, Kitova. She will feel that she has a point to prove. She was disappointed not to be amongst the medals in Madrid on Sunday. And with under two laps to go, Kirsty McDermott is trying to get that performance out of her system in the best possible way.
Every time that Kirsty moves up onto the shoulder of Kitova, she obviously, Kitova increases the pace, and she's, by doing that, they're actually breaking the rest of the field. It should be quite an interesting race, because both of these girls up front are really fast when it comes to the last lap. Kirsty's looking very determined, and one can only hope with a lap to go, she's going to really push the pace over the last lap.
Well, two girls who are better used to 800 metre running than 1500, and they're going to have a battle royal Kitova over this final lap. Kitova leads. McDermott pursuing her with that look of determination on her face that we saw so often in her marvellous 1985. She's getting all the help she needs from the crowd. Can she pull back the gap? I doubt it. Kitova stretching away. McDermott's legs just won't carry her through. But still, she will take second place behind the Russian. Kitova wins it in 4 minutes, 11.88. McDermott second, Murray third, Carter fourth. So Great Britain, in terms of the match, had two girls in the first three. And Yvonne Murray, not surprisingly, looking a little tired after her marvellous efforts of the weekend. So, a fine victory for Kitova. Peter.